You. Hey, what you been doing, man? It looked like you.
Never mind what it looked like because you didn't see anything, understand?
You don't tell me what I did and didn't see. I said it looked.
Shut your goddamn mouth.
Those are some mighty big words for such a little boy. In fact, you best to be careful these next couple of days, because you're probably gonna fall down. Have an accident.
You understand me, Miller?
Okay, man, okay. Anything you say, man. Anything. Sorry.
That's it. I've had it with you. You're going into isolation for the next 2 weeks. Sands? Sands, where the hell are you? Okay, what's going on here, Miller?
Roger?
Hello, Mother.
What are you doing here?
I came back.
Why aren't you at school?
I came back to see you.
Roger, you can't be seen here. I'm throwing a very important party and...
No one must know you have a son. Well, that's why I'm here, Mother. I'm sick of having to hide.
Roger.
I want people to know who I am.
No.
And I am your son.
Please.
But you are my mother.
I can't.
You are my mother!
Roger, stop it! Stop it, Roger!
Hey, what the hell are you doing here?
What?
I said, what the hell are you doing here?
Nothing. I'm not doing anything here.
Oh? Yeah, you vandals are all the same. I know your type. Well, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'm going to get the police up here. I'll get the police up here, I'll tell you.
I take it. You will.
Oh, no.
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 Oh, no. Don't you ever give up?
Lieutenant Barrett.
How'd you expect?
This is Davis. I'm sorry to disturb you, Lieutenant.
So why did you?
We have a 187.
Why call me?
Captain Wells wants you in on it. That's all I know.
Tell Captain Wells to shove it.
I'm telling myself, Barrett, just as soon as you get your ass in high gear.
Okay.
And pick up Holt on the way.
Come on, Captain. Why Holt?
Ta-da! You said this was your day off.
It was.
Dessert yet. I'll save it for you. Aren't you going to wear the boots I bought you?
No.
Mm-hmm. I thought you said you threw those old shoes out.
I lied.
Candy just wants you to look neat, that's all.
In the middle of the night, Candy?
Mm-hmm. You want me to wait up for you, Teddy Bear? No. Okay, for you.
Later.
Have a nice time.
Apparently strangulation, Lieutenant. Her larynx appeared to be totally crushed. No doubt by a pair of large and extremely strong hands. But don't call me on that until after the autopsy.
Okay, Jim, can I report as soon as possible?
All right.
Don't forget that telephone.
Lieutenant, it's just like the front door. Everything in this place is locked on the inside. It's really funny.
What's funny, Sergeant?
Well, I mean, with all the windows and the doors locked from the inside. Now, Lieutenant, will you tell me how the guy got out of here?
You tell me. Get all the information from her boyfriend?
Oh, yeah. He's a little shook up, but I think he's in the clear.
Holt.
Kevin Kingley was supposed to pick up the girl at 9 o'clock. She didn't answer the door. Her car was still in the garage. She didn't answer the phone when he called from the manager's office. He went up there and kicked in the door. He found the girl dead in the bathtub. Then he called the police. The phone in the den. Is that all right with you, Lieutenant Barrett, sir?
Was the manager with him when he busted in?
I forgot to ask.
Ask.
Yes, sir. Lieutenant, she was with him when he broke in.
You a married man, Mr. Kingsley?
I don't think I have to answer that question.
What?
Listen, Lieutenant, I'm not trying to be evasive. I'd like to avoid an ugly scandal if possible.
It's already ugly. And I can make it a hell of a lot worse.
I've been seeing Mr. Long about 6 months. But I assure you, there's never been the slightest complications. Arguments, threats, marriage. None of those things.
She ever mention anyone giving her a bad time?
You mean, did men make advances to her? I suppose every man she encountered would like to have taken her out.
You know what I mean, Mr. Kingsley. Crazies, freaks.
She used to get obscene telephone calls from someone. But that stopped when she had her number changed and unlisted.
Phone free.
Mr. Kingsley, you can go. Don't get lost. I may need to talk to you again.
This is a left thumbprint we took from the bathroom doorknob. This is one from the bedroom telephone.
They're identical.
And this is Roger Sands' left thumbprint. They're identical, Lieutenant. Roger Sands was definitely in Darlene DeLong's apartment.
Roger Lewis Sands, male Caucasian, age 26, 6 foot, 165 pounds. Convicted for counts of first degree murder. Sentenced to life imprisonment in a North State institution for the criminally insane.
I studied this case in college. I called it the Celebrity Strangler. His victims were all well-known, actresses, foxes, the models, that type. In fact, his first victim was his own mother, that glamour girl of the 50s, Carlotta Sands.
Now I know why I asked the captain to put you on this case, Holt.
Well, Darlene DeLong was a key witness at the Sands trial. You've made an attempt on her life. There are two others that we know of. It's all here in this file. Now, both of these young women came dangerously close to losing their lives. Roxanne Raymond, a professional dancer, and Christina Hartman, that year's Miss Galaxy. Sands actually got his hands on her.
Captain Wells, here's the report from Warden Bowman.
Thank you. Well, that confirms it, Barrett. Sands escaped less than 48 hours ago.
Escaped for maximum security. Captain, who let him loose?
Now, don't start that again. Nobody let this one out.
What the hell is this supposed to mean? Escaped under mysterious circumstances. How's it going, Sloan?
No sweat so far.
What you got out there?
Sergeant Archer. And Kovacs is out on the beachfront. I think we got the place pretty well covered, Lieutenant.
You better know it's covered.
Who's there, please?
Lieutenant Barrett, I have an appointment with Mrs. Hartman. Mrs. Hartman? Mrs. Hartman, Lieutenant Barrett, I believe you got a call from my office.
Would you please tell me why those men are spying on me? It's David, isn't it? Playing one of his stupid little games again.
David, your husband?
Yes, my goddamned husband. Hey, say, you don't look like a detective.
Your husband has nothing to do with this, Mrs. Hartman. You remember a man named Roger Sands? The night before last, he killed a girl named Darlene DeLong.
Oh, my God. Oh, my dear God, that poor girl. He's out of prison.
And we have 4 men on duty around the clock.
That's good. Hey, what about that other girl? She was a dancer, Roxanne.
Yeah, Roxanne Raymond. We're trying to locate her now.
Would you like a drink, Lieutenant?
It's a little early in the day for me.
Yeah. Well, I think I'm going to have another one. You just took the edge off this one. Excuse me.
Where's your husband now, Mrs. Hartman?
Try Chris. My husband? I don't know. I never know half the time. In Europe someplace, France or Spain. You see, Dave is a habitual globetrotter. He collects visas like some men collect stamps.
Good beauty. You live here all alone?
Yeah, except for my housekeeper. It's a real drag, you know.
Yeah, I bet.
I think I'm gonna buy myself a puppy. Oh, I did love it at first. Oh, sure did. David and I spend much more time together then. Had lots of parties and friends. Took me with him everywhere. We traveled to Europe, met lots of important, famous people like dukes and princesses and ambassadors and even the queen.
Sounds like you had it all.
Yeah, I guess I have. But I don't anymore. David now treats me like I'm just another trophy in his collection. And you know what happens to yesterday's trophies, Lieutenant? They get dusty.
Still in love with him?
I guess so. I think so. I don't know. Hello? Hold on.
Barrett here.
Hey, Lieutenant. Finally located Roxanne Raymond. She's rehearsing her new show at the West Valley Theater. Wow, is it a wild number? You should... We're searching the place now.
Okay, you stay on top of it until I get there.
Right. Lieutenant! Hey, Lieutenant. Hey, look, how you doing with Miss Galaxy? I hear she's really... Huh?
Buddy, you finally got something right. Roxanne Raymond's okay.
Oh, that is great.
Okay, now you take care of yourself.
Lieutenant, can't you stay a while? I mean, I could make us a nice seafood salad with a real special sauce, huh?
How about a rain check? Mrs. Hartman.
Yeah?
Watch out for your friend here.
Oh. Up, down, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, darlings, let's try it again, and right this time. Take it from the top.
5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
7, 8, 6, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 7, 2, 3, 4, 5.
And lights, and first act curtain, and that's it, kids. Take a break, then we'll run through the second act. And Roxanne, darling, please, please, please try to pick up your cues. You know we open in 3 days.
Tell me, Doctor, did Sands ever discuss any of his victims with you?
Yes, quite freely on occasion. In one way or another, each of these young women reminds him of his mother. They were all cover girls, you know, Celebrity Magazine. In his mind, each time he kills, he actually believes he is killing her all over again. I'm afraid unless Roger Sands is stopped, he will be compelled to continue killing every woman who reminds him of his mother.
What are these books here in his cell?
I believe he's read every book in the prison library.
Yeah, but what are these?
Sands is well educated, you know. Actually, brilliant in some ways. It's not unusual in the case of the homicidal schizophrenic.
Did he ever mention any friends? Did he write letters to anybody?
No, Roger Sands lived within himself. That's a basic symptom of his psychosis. His mother, not wanting known that she had a child, prevented him from developing any friendships.
That didn't help us a whole lot.
Does Sands have any interests, sports, automobiles, political organizations, anything at all?
Yes, psychic phenomena. It was his major preoccupation. Obsession, I should say.
Are you suggesting that's how he escaped?
I'm simply suggesting that Roger Sands was experimenting with ESP. For instance, I once found him in a total cataleptic state. He was lying on the floor of his cell, as rigid as this desk. We at first thought he was dead, but the medical staff detected a heartbeat. After about 20 minutes, he came out of it.
I don't see how that's going to help us find the bastard.
The ESP Research Institute seems to think it might. They've had a team of parapsychologists studying the case since it reached us. You've no doubt heard of Darwin Van Cott?
Psychometrist, yes.
Yes. Well, he and Dr. Ulmer, the head parapsychologist from the Institute, spent considerable time in the subject's cell, where Van Cott could be in physical contact with the object used by Roger Sands. I taped the session. Would you care to hear it?
Yes, please.
Yes, Dr. Ulmer. I seriously believe this Roger Sands could be here in this room with us, and we would be unable to see him.
Dr. Jacobs, could you play that again?
Certainly.
Yes, Dr. Ulmer. I seriously believe this Roger Sands could be here in this room with us, and we would be unable to see him.
Married at the age of 17, had one child, one Roger Lewis Sands. Became instant star in her first picture, age 19. She dumped her husband. Not remarry, but man, did she ever keep the scandal sheets alive with her active? I think that's mine. I had the one with the mustard. Carlotta Sands, known to have regretted having a child, got in the way of her social life. She kept her son in boarding school most of the time, away from her friends all of the time. Carlotta Sands, strangled to death in the bedroom of her West Park mansion 6 years ago by one Roger Lewis Sands. Since that time, the estate has been in the hands of the probate court.
it! Why are you acting this way, Roger?
Because you are my mother.
You're such a child. Don't you see what it'll do to us if people find out about you?
Where do you get this us stuff, Mother? All you've ever cared about was you. What it will do to you. It can't get any worse for me. It's like I've been invisible all my life. And I just can't do it anymore.
Roger, I've had enough trouble as it is. If people find out I have a son your age, it will ruin me.
Then get ready to be ruined, Mother, because I'm busting this thing wide open.
I wish you had never been born.
I wish you'd never been born.
Something, wouldn't she? Amazing how many brides like her get all screwed up. Wind up just another vital statistic.
Let's start with the bedroom.
Someone was in here. How the hell did they get out?
Get out on the car and call in a search assist. I want this whole area cordoned off.
Yes, sir.
Hunt, keep up with the pool, okay?
Yes.
I got it spreading out all over, Lieutenant.
You ever hear of a Colleen Hudson?
Yeah, she's a socialite. Always making news of the international jet set.
Find her and fast. Put her under protection. She may be the next one up.
Yes, sir.
You behave. Prince, quiet. Now down. Prince, come back here. Rabbit, you're not.
Birthday.
I always do.
Yeah.
Candy has another surprise for you.
Save me.
Come on, sit down over here and close your eyes. Come on. Hurry up.
Okay.
Are you sitting down?
No, not yet.
Are your eyes closed?
No. Just
hurry up.
Okay.
Ready?
Ready.
Ta-da! Happy birthday.
That's really something.
You see, I told you I was good at something else.
Did you make
it? From scratch. I've been slaving away in the kitchen all day. Come on, blow it out. Make a wish and blow out the candle. Come on. Yay! Cheers. And now, Candy is going to cook you a birthday dinner.
Really?
Would you like chicken and giblets? Or a fillet of sole?
How about macaroni and cheese? Is that a new coat?
Yes. It's your birthday present to me. Did you catch your maniac yet?
No.
Oh, that's too bad. Well, maybe you'll get him tomorrow. Oh, good. What's his birth sign?
Whose birth sign?
Your maniac.
Candy, I don't know his birth sign.
Oh, you don't?
No.
Oh, okay.
No, I don't believe you. Are you for real?
You want me to prove it to you or something?
To you, not so.
What are you doing back here? Theater's closed.
I work here. Yeah, I'm a stagehand.
Theater's still closed. Come over here.
Damn line's been busy.
Okay, well, what is it?
Found Colleen Hudson. In the morgue. strangle?
Yeah, Evergreen Park. Same M.O., no witnesses, no apparent motive. The body's covered with jewelry.
Any evidence?
Yeah, she had a guard dog with her. Dog was clubbed to death. Roger Sands prints all over the club. Look, the captain's pretty uptight, Lieutenant. He told me to tell you he's giving you Russo and Harris and checking out the other girl.
That one, how?
He also told me to tell you to get your damn phone fixed. Hey, he said it, I didn't.
Want some coffee?
No, thanks. You mind if I just flake up?
Said, make us some coffee.
I'm counting, Candy. I'm almost to 10.
Thinking. Don't you think it would be better if you got some other kind of a job? You know, like a bank manager or an engineer or something with normal working hours.
I'll give it some thought.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, could you water my plants today?
Mm-hmm. Have a nice time.
What's with that?
Sergeant. Time is Roxanne Raymond's dress rehearsal.
3:30 this afternoon.
Okay, I'll see you then. Between now and then, don't let that girl out of your sight.
We got 3 men in her apartment.
I want you inside the apartment with her. Stick to her like a band-aid. Till she gets to the theater, you eat with her, you ride with her, you take a bath with her if necessary.
Wow, what a place.
Hey, if Roxanne Raymond gets hinky on you, you tell her we'll take her into protective custody. If you need me, I'll be at the ESP Research Institute.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Akeem.
So, that's psychokinesis.
Well, one manifestation of it. Now, some psychics have the power to move objects from great distances. That's telekinesis.
Are you trying to tell... Are you trying to tell me that a man could strangle someone from a distance?
Lieutenant, there are many mysterious phenomena that can't be explained. My file cabinets are filled with records of them. The Bellwitch of Springfield, Tennessee, the poltergeist, responsible for the death of a member of the Bell family. The Charles King murder case of Canada. Now, the brother of this victim had a vision of the entire incident while asleep in his home in England. And his description of the murderer led to the arrest of the man, even before news of the event had reached London. Now, these are all well-documented cases.
Dr. Ulmer, all this is driving me up the wall. Now, if you people know something that'll help me find this guy, just give it to me straight.
Lieutenant, here at the Institute, we investigate mysterious phenomena. We don't create it.
Okay. Okay. What did your psychic, Van Cott, mean when he said Roger Sands could be in the same room with you and you wouldn't be able to see him?
I don't know what he meant.
Well, you must have some theory about all this.
Yes, that's just what it is, theory. Some form of astral projection. Out-of-body travel, Lieutenant.
The astral traveler usually visits places and persons he knows. Distance seems to be no barrier. A great number of cases that are thoroughly documented on this tool. And as far as we know, the astral traveler's real body always remains at the place of departure. But who is to say that Roger Sands hasn't gone a step beyond? Cut the silver cord, perhaps. Reached into some new dimension.
You really think that's possible, don't you?
Well, after 12 years with the Institute, I'm convinced that if the will of the human mind is strong enough, anything is possible.
Yeah. Well, thank you for your time, Dr. Ulmer.
Not at all, and feel free to call me at any time.
Dr. Ulmer. Only a handful of people on the force know the details of this case. So far, we've been able to keep those details out of the news. But if the media should get wind of your theory and... well, they'd make us look like a three-ring circus, you know?
I understand.
What you got, Russo?
Me and the other girl, Bambi Greer. She's an actress, big deal in the late 60s.
She's living at the marina, Dolphin Apartments, but she's not home.
Did you alert the department down there?
And the Harbor Patrol.
Casey's your baby. Get down there and find her.
Right.
And let me know as soon as you do.
You bet.
Piano, but then I should be. I started playing when I was 7 years old. You know, when your parents are Norwegian and German, there's got to be music in the house. Hey, I'm glad you came by. It's damn lonely around here sometimes, like now. Sit down.
Yeah, it must, but that's not why I'm here.
No, I didn't think it was. Too early in the day for you, I suppose.
Yeah, right. My men out front tell me you've been giving them a hard time.
Yeah, I guess I have. You know, when I get too lonely or too upset, I usually take a ride up the coast with the top down. Have lunch in Santa Barbara, dinner in Carmel. Nice.
Alone?
Yes, unfortunately alone, Lieutenant. Drive kind of helps me get my head straight. You know, sometimes I drive up into the mountains, forest country. Boy, I love the smell of pine trees. Have you ever taken a pine needle and kind of bitten it and then smelled it? Wow. Reminds me of home. But those idiots out there won't let me go anyplace. Not even down to my own beach.
It's, gonna get worse before it gets better. I've gotta take you into protective custody.
Like hell you will. I've had about all the confinement I can take, Charlie.
Just trying to keep you from getting yourself killed.
Well, if you think I'm gonna sweat it out in some stinking little room while you and your guys chase that nut, you're out of your mind.
Listen. I've just found out that we're not dealing with some ordinary... I mean, this Roger Sands, he's elusive as hell. And until I know more about him, I need all the cooperation I can get.
Well, I'm gonna stay right here, and if you don't like it, you know where you can go. And you might just as well take those bastards out there with you. I want you all off my property. Do you understand that? Do you?
All right, I'll give you a choice. Either you come with me, or you stay locked in this house until I say it's okay.
You can take your choice and shove it, okay?
Why don't you stop drinking that crap and grow up?
Now, where do you get off telling me how to live my life?
That's the way it's gonna be, Mrs. Harton. Or I'll get a court order and haul your ass in.
Lousy, goddamn damn police force. Get the hell out of this house. Get the hell out of this house and leave me alone. Get out of this house!
Didn't I?
You told me. Is that our girl?
Yeah. See, the witches are trying to catch her, and then she's supposed to be sacrificed for that big demon guy up there.
Got anybody up there?
You bet your sweet ass. Yes, sir.
How many stagehands?
There's six, and I got someone watching every one of them.
To tell me what the hell you're mixed up with.
I told you. I'm not mixed up in anything.
Then why is the harbor patrol sitting out there on the deck of my yacht?
I don't know.
I ought to hurt my head examining fooling around with a girl like you.
Why are you so uptight? I'm the one they're worried about.
Why the hell are they worried?
Well, I don't know, Mario. I don't know.
So help me, Bambi. If you get me mixed up in some goddamn dirty mess, I'll see that you never work in another picture the rest of your life.
big man.
I would love to hear with your music is stupid music.
Aboard a yacht. The dockmaster here said they left early this morning.
Is she under guard?
I radioed the dockmaster before I put in the call for you. Harbor police over there should be aboard with her by now.
I guess she's about as safe out on a yacht like that as any place, Lieutenant.
I hope you're right, Sergeant.
Bambi? Bambi?
Thank you.
Oh, here.
Is it hot enough to kill a man?
No, but it sure as hell knock you on your ass.
How about the fence?
Well, breaking it sets off an alarm up in the house.
Uh-huh. Rolled up. Her old man's a nut on security, sir.
How's it going, Colbert?
No problems yet. Good morning, Captain.
Good morning.
You'd have a pretty tough time trying to make it up this way.
Rubats, this is Sloan. Is a lieutenant anywhere near you?
Yeah, Sloan, go ahead.
Utility squad is here.
You check their IDs?
They're okay.
Let them in. Lock the gate behind them.
Right, sir.
You're clear.
Do all the men understand what we're up against?
I've told them everything I know.
I'm not so sure we shouldn't get that girl out of here. Put on a plane to Europe or somewhere until we know what the hell this is all about.
I don't know. That wouldn't stop Sands from killing it. It's not Christina Hartman. It'll be some other lady.
How's Holt working out?
Not as bad as I thought. But he's not as good as he thinks he is. Hell, you know, I'll probably be working for him 5 years from now.
Okay, Chuck, you got the ball.
It's tied into the 220 circuit in the utility room.
Is that enough?
More than enough, the way we're wiring it. But he's got to make contact with the metal handrailing, Lieutenant.
Why don't you just wire the steps?
What? You have to cover them all with metal plates. That'd be pretty hard to hide.
All right, Russo, as soon as they get that switch wired, you stay within hand's reach. If I give you the word to hit it, you hit it no matter what, okay?
Okay.
Remember, if you see anything unusual or hear anything unusual, let me know.
Right.
Sloan.
Go ahead, Lieutenant.
Listen, it's almost dark. Call Archer. I want him to take over your station. I want you here inside.
Okay, Lieutenant.
On the double, Sloan. Holt. Sergeant Holt.
What?
Yes, sir.
Take over here. I'm going upstairs.
Got all dressed up to have a little drinky with myself.
I told you to stay in your room with the doors locked.
When will you stop treating me like a child? I know what I'm doing, okay?
Yeah, you sure do. You're half smashed already.
Yes, sir. Warden, lieutenant. And pretty soon I'll be totally smashed. You'll help.
Like hell you will.
Listen, Chris, just try to lay off that damn stuff, will you? I need your help.
Look, I'm sorry, okay? I really am sorry. I guess I'm just a little scared, Lieutenant, scared.
Hey. Try Chuck, okay?
Okay. Chuck.
Did you reach your husband?
Yes, in Rome. He'll be here in the morning.
That's bad?
I don't know. Hey, Chuck, may I ask you something?
Go ahead.
Do you think if I tried to be more like the girl he found in Green Valley, I could get him back? You know, a simple country girl in blue jeans and pigtails?
That's what you're worried about? Well, he must have wanted a country girl when he married you. It's worth a try.
I hope so, because if that's what it takes, I'm sure gonna do it. Yeah. And then I'm gonna take that son of a bitch for everything he's got. When I get through with him, he'll have to float alone to make a telephone call.
Yeah, Archer, what is it?
Sergeant Davis is here.
Tell her to come upstairs, through the patio entrance. Davis is your babysitter. You do whatever the hell she says. Understand?
Okay, Charlie. You too, Junior.
You too, Junior. You too, Junior.
On that bird.
Come on, Samuel. Want a drink? Want a drink, sweetheart?
Oh, shove it up. Good night, sweetheart.
North fence. Stay here.
Well, come on.
Russo, pull that switch. Get Archer in here and put in a call for an ambulance. Let's get Chris out of here.
Terrace.
Huh. Archer, stand by on the patio. Hold upstairs with Chris and don't touch that railing.
Come on!
Thank you.
against the wind. You can't hide me anymore. And I want everyone to know that you are my mother.
Thank you.
Șamponul preferat al copilului.